Okay, well, this video is going to be on subnetting, and I'm going to show you my way to do subnetting. There's a few different ways to do subnetting, but this is the way that I have found to be the easiest. So I'm going to make some assumptions that you already know about the basics of dotted decimal and decimal to binary conversion in this video, that you've already got a handle on that. So we're going to use the dotted decimal number, IPv4 address of 192.168.10.0/24. The 24 just means that our subnet mask of 255.255, and my handwriting is not the best in the world, so I apologize for that. So 255, I'll have to slow down here. I get moving really fast. So 255.255.255.0, that's our subnet mask because we're using the first 24 bits in the subnet mask for our network. So this is our network, this is our host. So we know now, by this IP address and this slash 24, we know that we have one subnet and we have how many hosts per subnet? Well, we know that we're using the last octet, so we know we have to use the zero. We have to use the zero as our network ID, and we have to use the 255 as our broadcast ID because our first IP address is zero, and that's our network. Our last IP address is our broadcast, and then so 1 to 254, and any number in between is our host. So that's our and that's our network ID. That's our broadcast ID, and these are our host IDs that we can pass out for this subnet. But let's say that you are told that you need to, and you're probably going to see questions like this. You're going to see, I need two subnets, and I need 12 hosts on one subnet and 20 hosts on the other subnet. So how do you figure that out? And there's a lot of different ways to do it. And I'm going to erase some of this here. And I'm going to move this up here. Let's move this here so I've got this. And let me erase. Tell you what, let me erase all of this here. So we go back here, and we're going to go 192.168.10/24 is going to be our IP address. And we're given the scenario. Let's say that we're given the scenario that we need two subnets, and we need two subs, and we need 12 hosts on one subnet, and we need 20 on the other subnet. Now, like I said, there's a lot of different ways to do this, but I have found the easiest way is to just write a little simple chart out. And my chart is this way. I just start over here on the right-hand side, and I write 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. That's my 8-bit places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Some people like to draw the lines in there. I'm not good at drawing lines. I'm not good at drawing lines in. They make my hands hurt when I draw a lot of lines, but you can draw lines in there, and you can draw lines across this way. This works really well for when you go in for exams and you need to, before you start the exam, and you're usually given a whiteboard, and you want to write out to do quick and easy subnetting. You can write this chart out at the beginning of the exam, and then you have it for reference. So we know that our subnet IDs are. At this point right now, we're at 255.255. Well, my pen keeps wanting to grab my screen and move around. There we go. 255, let me erase this little bit right here. 255.255.0. Now, what we're going to do is we need to subnet this out, and we need to figure out how many hosts we need and how many subnets we're going to need. So if I write from left to right and do 1, 2, 4, 8, all the way up to 128, and then I start in the 8-bit place here, or the first place, and I write 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, and 256. Now, I know that when I look at this, if I'm borrowing my bit places, we're assuming that we're using 0.0.0. The first three octets are already used because we already have those turned on, but we're going to subnet into this last octet. We're going to borrow our bit places here. So what I do is I usually go ahead and make this a little bit more detailed, and I say this is my slash 24. Or I have already 24 turned on, so this is slash 25. This is slash 26. 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, and 32. So those are my last 8-bit places. You don't have to use the slash if you don't want to, because that just takes up extra space, but you could if you wanted to. And then I draw one more line above that, and these are going to be my mask numbers. These are my subnet masking numbers. So we know if I borrow 1-bit place, it's going to be 128 binary. So I know it's going to be 128. But if I borrow 2-bit places, it's going to be 128 plus 64. So if I do 128 plus 64, that's 1192. And then the next bit place would be 192 plus 32. And so 192 plus 32 is 1224, excuse me. So we do 224. And then 224 plus 16 is our next place. So we do plus 16. And then we get the 240. We get 240. So we're just using the powers of 2 in binary here. And then 240 plus 8 is 248. And then 248 plus 4 is 252. And then 252 plus 2 is 254, and then we have 255. Those are our subnet masking numbers. So if we borrow 1-bit place, our subnet for our last octet becomes 128. If we borrow 2-bit places, our subnet mask for our last octet becomes 192, and then 224, 240, 248, and so on. And so by writing this chart down, we have a quick and easy reference to be able to say what is our what is our bit places that we're borrowing, 25, 26, 27. What's our subnet mask when we borrow into that bit place? And then this next lines down here that we already wrote out, these are going to be how many subnets we get. This is going to be our number of subnets, number of subs, and this is going to be our number of host minus two. So, if we say we need two subnets, we need two subnets, and the first subnet needs 20 host, and the next subnet needs 12 host, we can look at our chart here and we can say, well, we know we've got to get two subnets out of borrowing 1-bit. We know that. But we're going to get 126, because remember, this is 128 minus 2. We're going to get 126 host out of this one. We're going to get 126 host out of here. We're going to get 62 host out of here, out of the 26-bit place. We're going to get 32 out of here, and we're going to get 16 out of here. So the rule of thumb is you make your subnets as you go ahead and break your subnets down as small as possible, or as many subnets as you can get, because we'll actually get 8 subnets. So we're going to get 8 subnets, but we only have to provide 2 of them for the exercise. So since we only have to provide 2 of them, let's scroll down here just a little bit here. So we're going to provide 2 subnets, but we need to have at least 20 hosts in one and 12 in the other. Now we could break this into 2 subnets and we could have 126 hosts per. But let's just say that we want to leave a little bit of room for growth. So let's go on down here to the 8th, the 27th bit place here. We're going to borrow 3 bits over into the last octet. And that's going to give us 8 subnets and 30 host per subnet. Well, we can't use the next one because that only gives us 16 places, and this is not VLSM. This is not variable length subnet mask. This is just simple subnetting, so don't worry about that yet. Now, what I do is I take my IP number that I started with, and my IP number, my network ID for this, because we know it's a slash 24, we know our network number is actually 0. So we're going to come down here and we're going to write our first number out, and we're going to say that's 192.168.10.0. This is our first network ID on our first subnet. So what I'm going to do then is I know that my subnets are going to go in increments of 32, because my first IP address is a network ID, and we're going to go 30 increments of 32. So I'm just going to write down here, and I'm just going to assume that this is x.x.x 192.168.10. And you can draw lines if you want to. I could probably use an Excel chart, but I usually just draw little lines out here, and I just keep this simple. And I do 32, and then I go increments of 32. So 32 and 32 is 64. 64 and 32 is 4. That's 6. 6, 7, 8, 9. And then 96 plus 32, 128. We just keep drawing our lines out here. And I'm going to scroll down here just a little bit because we already have our top chart up there. And I'll leave it on the screen so you can copy that format if you need to. And then we have 128, and then another 32 is 8, 9, 10. And then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that's 160. And then I'm going to move my background here down just a hair. Okay, then we get the 160, and then we add 32 to that. So we get, let me draw my line here. I need to do 160 plus 32 is 2, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's 192. And then 4, and then 9, 10, 11, 12, and then 224, and then 4, 5, 6, and then 5, and then we end up with 256, which we know that is the end of our subnets. So we should have 8 subnets, because remember, we borrowed 3 bits, and that gave us 8 subs, so 1 sub, you know, that subnet, we can letter these A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we know we have those subs now. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a different color here because I'm going to do my host range and my broadcast and we know this is my network. And so I'm going to do my network, my host range, and my broadcast in different colors here. So I'm just going to draw, this is my basic chart I'm drawing here. So we're going to do the next number, and now what I'm going to do is for my host range here, for my host range, I'm just going to increase by 1 because we know the next number up is my first number in my host range. So I just write a 1 there. I write a 33 there, 65 there, 97, 129, 161, 193, 225, and that's my last range. And then to get my last host number and my broadcast ID, I'm just going to turn on and say, let's turn on purple for this, and let's go for my broadcast ID over here. For my broadcast, I'm going to back off one number. So 32 minus 1 is 31, and then this one's going to be 63 because that's one less than 64, and then 95, 127, 159, 191, 223, 255, because one less than 256. And then when I turn my, and then I just back off one number from there. So that's 30, 62, 94, 126, 158, 190, 222, and 254. So now I've got my 8 subnets, and I know that my network IDs are right here for each one of these subnets. My host IDs are right here, and my broadcast IDs are out there. So these are each one of my subnets. Now, I have answered the question. I have at least 2 subnets, one with 12 hosts, and one with 20 hosts, because I know that each one of these have 30 hosts in them. So then I can go give these out. And if the question is, what is the network address of your first subnet? So, and I'm gonna use a second subnet on this so I can just write this out. So my network ID for my first subnet is 192.168.10.32/, I'm gonna do slash 20, and then remember we borrowed 3 bits, so we had 24 bits already, 25, 26, 27, so that's going to be a slash 27. And my next subnet is going to be 192.168.10.64/27. So that when you do the subnetting, if I'm given the IP address of 192.168.10.64/27, I'm going to know I can subnet this back out, and I can back into this chart, and I can say that 32 less than 64 is 32, because I can look at my chart up here and I can say a slash 27, I count by 32. So I can use this little handy chart here to go backwards or forwards. So I'm just going to leave this on the screen for a second just so you can see this. This is the chart I write out, and I know it looks sloppy, but I wanted to do it by handwriting because that's how you're going to do before a test. And this is how I practice. I practice with a pencil and a pen and a piece of paper when I have some extra time, and I start the chart out, and I start at 1, double it up, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. I go down one line and go back to 4, 8, 16. That's my number of subs, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256. On the next line, I show my bit value places, or my bit places, 25, 26, 27, 28. Then I write my subnet mask on there. So now if I was to say I need two subs, one with 12 and one with 20, so the first one is 192.168.10.32. If I was to write the subnet for that, or let's write the subnet mask for this .64, that would be 255. We already know the first three octets are 255, so we would have 255, 255, 255, and all we have to do is look up at our chart now. So slash 27 we know is a 224. I don't have to do the math already because I've already done that. So that subnet mask is 224. So that's basic subnetting for the last octet. Now for the third octet or the second octet, it gets a little bit more complicated, but it's really still using this chart. We're just adding numbers in both octets, and I'll have another video later on how to do that, how to subnet for the second or third octet, and this one is for the fourth octet. This is for your basic subnetting for a Network Plus exam, and I'm also going to have a video on how to do the anding, so how that you can tell how to find, see an IP address and tell which subnet it's in. And that's basically, we'll use some of this chart here in that as well. But this video was on basic subnetting. I hope this was helpful. Again, this is the chart here that you want to memorize how to write. And then you can take this chart and build your subnet chart out. And it comes in real handy on exams.